A few words, perhaps, about to start about what you said for what happened in the U.S. and in the French West Indies at CNES, which is a French space agency. We organize a chart to be sure that when we have hurricanes or earthquake, all the satellites which are going to overfly these regions in the hours after this big event, all the satellites are going to take pictures of the ground. And this is why after the big floods in Texas, we got radar images of the satellites allowing to see where there were a big flood and where there was a lot of water. And in the French West Indies, we got the first images from what happened in Saint-Barthélemy and Saint-Martin to organize all the organization of the rescue. And as you said, satellites are very, very useful. But today I'm going to speak about another use of satellite, which is the use of satellite to allow autonomous vehicles. And in particular, I would like to speak about Europe's Galileo geolocation, which will enable such autonomous vehicles in the future. So, Galileo is today a constellation of 18 satellites. So it means that we have been launching during the last years 18 satellites. And it is already delivering promising levels of performance. And it affords a much better precision than any other satellite navigation system currently available. To be very blunt, if you take the GPS, you know that you are in the Four Seasons here in Marrakech. If you take Galileo, you know if you are here on the stage or in the room. It's very, very important, and it makes, but the truth, and it makes the difference. And we are going to continue to launch satellites. The next one is planned in French Guiana with an Ariane 5 on the 12th of December. And so we will have the full constellation by 2020. And there are 4 points on which I would like to insist to explain why Galileo is such a great asset for autonomous vehicles. The first one is a service offering 10-meter accuracy around the globe. And as I said, Galileo is even more accurate than the GPS. The second point is an authentication service that allows users to ensure they are receiving the right signals and not being spoofed. It's very, very important, in particular, when you have to deal with insurance or to make, for instance, micro-trading, to know exactly when an event occurs with an accuracy which is something as 1/10⁻⁹ seconds. The third point is enhanced signals to assure better positioning resilience in urban environments, because I spoke about, of course, positioning here, but if you have skyscrapers and so on, it may be difficult. And so Galileo is very, very useful for that. And last but not least, it's the close interoperability with GPS designed into the system from the outset. And now I would like to say in a few words some of the key issues facing autonomous vehicles where Galileo is going to be instrumental. The first point, the first issue is institutional and regulatory. Any discussion about driverless vehicles is bound to touch on road safety. Today, safety, of course, is mostly in the hands of drivers. When you drive a car, you are in charge of the safety of the car. But tomorrow, we are going to see a new paradigm where safety will be assured by autonomous systems. And for one of the main challenges ahead may seem something of a paradox, as governments must both guarantee road safety and boost innovation. Cooperation between the public and private sectors therefore appears vital to progressively build a regulatory framework that favors innovation while retaining tight control over safety. Driverless vehicles are also an international issue. It seems obvious, but we have today international accords like the Vienna and Geneva Conventions of Road Traffic, and they seek to improve road safety by harmonizing regulation in signatory nations. And work, of course, is underway to include autonomous vehicles in these international treaties, because once we have autonomous vehicles, it will be too late to change the regulation. And so it is why it is so important to start right now. The second issue is of a technological and industrial order. Fully autonomous vehicles are not going to start operating overnight. Industry plans to roll out solutions ranging from limited autonomy to full autonomy over more than 10 years. Today, 5 levels of autonomy have been standardized, level 5 being that of a fully autonomous vehicle. Driverless vehicles will need to be geolocated very precisely, and nowadays we are hearing that a vehicle's onboard positioning system must be accurate to within half the width of a tire, which is, let us say, 10 to 20 centimeters. It's very, very accurate, as a matter of fact, because you must have the same accuracy everywhere on the surface of the Earth. Positional accuracy is important, but so is positional integrity, which is the confidence we have in it. If the system gives a position, but if you don't trust it, of course, it is completely meaningless. And even before technical solutions are matured, we need to address the issue of how driverless vehicles will be certified. This is another very, very important point, and it seems increasingly likely that we will adopt a building block approach focusing on subsystem level. It is clear that although Galileo is a reality, we still have much work to perform to get its services into the architecture of vehicles, even if it has been said on some vehicles, as Tesla, it is already very well matured. The last point is how industry organizes itself in this respect, because we need to have a very strong organization on the industrial side. Driverless vehicles are fueling fierce competition to develop new technologies in the automobile sector, especially with the arrival of the GAFA, and the data-driven culture that will be key to their development. In this context, most automobile manufacturers have decided to engage in this competition by nurturing their own ecosystem rather than going it alone. So, in a nutshell, you clearly understood that autonomous vehicles are coming, but it will be difficult, but I am sure that it will bring a lot of benefit. And to conclude, I would like to say that there is a strong need to conduct trials to allow industry to craft innovations for autonomous vehicles and to give governments enough data to inform policy decisions and legislation. From this point of view, cooperation between the public and private sectors will be a guarantee of success in this regard. I'm certain that addressing this point, as we are doing today very quickly, will be very, very helpful. But on this point, as on many other points with innovation, things are going very, very quickly. And today, it seems very strange to have a car driving alone, but I am sure that within a few years, we will be able to drive, for instance, from Casablanca to Marrakech without driver. It will take just a few years. In the US, we start to have some experimentations with some social issues. In the US, you have 5 million of truck drivers. They clearly understood that with such vehicles, they will lose their jobs. But such vehicles will bring a lot of benefits, and this is exactly what is at stake. Thank you.